salutations, my internet hellions. Welcome to the show. I am your host, Helson the Yes. And we are back at Edgewater. And we are going to collect some fees.
Almost lost a finger in the cannon.
We've got the gravesite fees that we need to collect. Oh, that's right, the crazy dude. He's in here. And then we're going to go collect the book for Vicar Max. And then we're going to go do the other stuff. I think, what else is there? I know there's something else.
Yes, Mr. Thompson. I'm fine, Mr. Thompson. Never been healthier. Well, did Mr. Thompson send you? Well, you tell Mr. Thompson I'll be right at my post tomorrow. Bright and early tomorrow, because I'm definitely not plagued. As spry as a spring chicken. That's old Abernathy.
Yeah. Don't tell me what's got you so nervous?
You're an alienist? Walking into a man's own domicile, pestering him about his mental state?
Yes, I am. I'm here to collect your gravesite fees.
That's why he does. That's why he wants me to pay up. He knows.
Yeah, I can. Do I want to do that? Yes, I do, because it's going to give me experience in line.
He's already told you.
Yep.
May as well hear it from me.
I already know.
I'm not long for this world. The date of my expiration is fast approaching. And soon I shall be ushered through the great cannery in the skies.
Don't say that, Mr. Abernathy. You still got a couple decades in you?
I'd steer clear, Ms. Holcomb. My affliction's bound to be contagious. It's plague. Has to be. Silas knows. He knows I got one foot in my grave, and now he wants to charge me for the other one.
You're being paranoid.
I am? Law, help me. Paranoia is one of the plague's
symptoms. Oh, God,
you're
one of those people.
I'll pay your fees. I don't want any trouble from Silas. But if you could see a way to freelancing for me, I could really use the help.
Depends on what you need.
A couple hours out of your day and some light second story work, that's all. There's a cache of anthracillin tucked away in the old community center. Powerful stuff.
I knew it!
Nab that medicine and bring it back to me.
That's the medicine I found.
Ground down into marauder meat? Let's see it. Don't keep us waiting.
Yeah, that's why you're ordering. I don't care.
Life-given nostrum. The first hit's always the best. Scratched together all the bits I had around the domicile. It ain't as much as you deserve, but it's all I got.
Yeah, I'm not gonna be a dick any more than I already have been. It's fine, whatever. Okay. So we've got Phyllis. She's in the cannery, right? Yep, there she is.
You the new worker? Whatever. Make it quick, Tenderfoot. I'm busy.
Call me Tenderfoot, bitch!
Silas still on about that?
Hell yeah, he is.
The fees. I'd appreciate it if you didn't tell Reed I was late on my payment.
There's a discrepancy here.
Because they're not my fees and not my gravesite. Guy I worked with shot himself. I paid the bill.
That's kind of you, I guess.
I'll do without the sarcasm. Wasn't acting out of the goodness of my heart. Law requires delinquent gravesite fees to be paid by the deceased party's closest living relative, which meant me. Shame, though. Eugene was a good worker.
Do I want to get myself into another... why not?
Woke up one morning and put a round through his upper story. Can't imagine why. The kid was doing all right at his desk. We all thought he was an upstanding receptionist. Just between the two of us, I'm pretty shocked his weapon didn't misfire. Spacer's Choice handguns aren't the most reliable.
That is an awful thing to say.
Not half as awful as the bill Eugene left us with.
Really?
Suicide's a crime. The legal term is irreparable damage to company property. What Eugene did to himself was vandalism.
Can't be serious.
In fact, I'm a little upset Eugene didn't think things through. In other words, Edgewater would have been penalized pretty hard. Whatever Eugene was worth as an asset, we would have had to pay out of pocket to Spacer's Choice.
I'm sorry, I have to reread this because I was laughing. So we would have had to pay out of pocket. What if you didn't?
Look around. Edgewater ain't exactly swimming in luxury. We can't afford to pay the body price of a suicide. All I know is Silas asked me for Eugene's gravesite fees, which means he was approved for burial, which means his papers went through, which means the town's in the clear. I'm just glad to put this whole ugly affair behind me. Eugene can rest his bones in peace, and the rest of us can get on with our own lives.
You are a cold-hearted bitch. Okay, that leaves one more person I need to collect from, which is the barber. You.
But Conrad sells real good disinfectant.
Please don't touch anything. Your hands are probably crawling with germs.
Oh, God.
Physical hygiene recapitulates moral hygiene. Cleanliness is next to lawfulness.
I can show you my hands.
No, thank you. That's quite all right. I've seen enough body parts in my line of work. I'm Conrad. You will report to me if your hair fails to meet Spacer's Choice aesthetic standards. You will also report to me in the event of your death, whereupon I will clean and prepare your remains for interment.
Silas sent me to collect your dues.
Gravesite fees. Silas and I had talked about this at length. I thought I'd made it clear my pecuniary situation precludes the necessary restitutions.
Okay, well, that makes more sense. You mean you're broke?
As broke as pie crust, friend. Bitless, indigent, destitute. I simply cannot afford it. I am a blemish on the prosperity of our fair settlement. When I expire...
Well, you are.
I expect Silas to toss my body into a ditch.
Okay, good. That's some quality drama.
Thank you, no. I despise the serials. Tell Silas I can't afford to pay, and that I fully expect to have my medical rights revoked for this dereliction. With my apologies.
Just give Silas an IOU.
Not a bad idea. But I'd need some kind of collateral. My pair of lucky clippers. No, that won't do. Your idea intrigues me, but I'm afraid I don't have anything to give Silas. I'm open to suggestions. Much obliged.
I have to close the door, Parvati. Sorry. There's bits to be had. Receptionist shot himself. This is bad. Company's gonna have to call it for what it is. Destruction of Spacer Choice property. So I was thinking we pawn off his teeth. Full set of gold teeth. Those are the gold teeth that I found. That was one of the bodies that they used. Oh, okay. Trying to steal things, Parvati, and you're making it very difficult for me to do that. Okay, gold teeth, buddy.
What can I do for you?
Where is this one going? I know a thing or two about medicine.
Am I in the company of a fellow doctor?
Of course you are.
I am a Spacer's Choice Certified Surgeon, and if you must know, I can stitch a severed thumb with a 58% chance of avoiding gangrene.
Ah, 58 points. Or 58%. That's great.
You know about Eugene?
I know about Eugene.
How?
Yes, I know. I found a note from Phyllis. Oh. I'm a mind reader.
You were probably poking around my things.
You're right.
I really shouldn't leave my letters sitting out in the open. Eugene's golden teeth were a family heirloom, representing three generations of poor dental hygiene. He took them to his grave.
I found him. You can have him.
Found Eugene's teeth? What? Where? How? The man was robbing his own graves without filing an invoice? This is a brazen violation of Spacer's Choice standard procedure. Thank you, I suppose. These, teeth should cover my fees nicely. My papers should be in order.
I don't want to get into that. Okay, let's go talk to Silas. Silas. Oh, Silas.
Hey, Miss Parvati. Come for a... Lovely to see you about, Miss Parvati.
Things going all right, Silas?
Been keeping him careful and true, miss.
What?
Best to ask her yourself.
My dad's buried here. Silas watches over him when I can't leave the house. Oh. Well, thanks.
Something I can do for you?
Yeah. What about...
Yeah? What about him? Well, yeah. It's what I'm contractually obligated to do. What's this about?
I don't know yet.
Yeah. Funny thing. Eugene's body ain't where it's supposed to be. The night we were supposed to commend his body to the earth, I had his grave all dug up and ready, right? And so I thought, I'll just rest my eyes a bit. When I woke up, his body was gone. Spirited away, vanished. The footprints nearby suggested that Eugene was stolen by marauders. Or he rose from the dead.
I'll keep an eye out for him.
Find anything.
I did, but anyway.
Any trouble?
No, not really. Here you go.
Reliable work from a freelancer. That's gonna take some getting used to.
Abernathy was trying to hide his own illness, and
he was sick with the plague. Yeah. That's disgusting. I shook hands with the guy.
Quit bitching.
What?
No. If I knew he was sick, I would have had him reported.
I needed his fees because of his name.
A, for Abernathy. He was at the top of my list, you see?
I'm not gonna try to pull more money out of these guys. Maybe later in other areas, depending upon how they are. But we are done with that one. So we've got the illustrated manual, which is retrieving a journal and then bringing it to Max. And then we've got Die Robot. So we got those two to do. So let's go to the book first because it's right over yonders.
I used to skip rocks in the river till Constable Reyes ticketed me for unlicensed terraforming. I think she was jealous. She don't know how to skip rocks her own self.
Is he scared? You're dead!
Everyone all right?
Well, I am now. Oh boy. Oh boy, you look like you're just resting. Okay. What's in the cave? I am gonna go exploring the cave. Oh, it's in the cave. Is it in the cave? It is in the cave. Oh, and there's... Hold on, Parvati. Hold on. Hold on. I can do this. Maybe? There we go. Is there anything else? I mean, I want to collect stoofs. There it is, journal. Okay. What? That's not a bad guy, that's a good guy. I am being shot at from all sides. Come on, die! Oh, shit! I thought I already killed all these guys. Where are they coming from? Jeez. I thought I killed all these guys. Why did they come back?
Aw, he ain't no threat. But I could fix...
Search.
I could probably fix that. I mean, if you wanted me to.
Go for it!
Yep, I see the problem. His nav mod got dislodged. Must have taken a tumble. Just gotta give it a good push and wait for the click. There we go. Jeremy's good as new. Well, new by Spacer's Choice standards anyhow. His name's Jeremy, by the by.
Navigation systems operational. Optimal path toward repair bay detected. Initiating self-diagnostics.
Why did you name... Well, no, I'm not even gonna ask that. And he's not... Good luck!
Be more careful out there, Jeremy.
Okay. Oh, Lutz!
Nope.
You don't have to worry about
you
that scout.
That scout to scrap with its own legs? Pulled its optic cables out its head case? Actually, don't tell me. Rather use my imagination.
You're a little nuts, aren't you?
You're a fair soldier, I will confess. But you are one. And the enemy is legion. What you need is an equalizer. A weapon to strike fear in their cold, mechanical hearts. Cantina, lavatory. Behind one of the toilets. That's where I've kept it hidden all these years.
You hid your secret.
Sharp, ain't it?
In a bathroom.
The very last place a mechanical has need to enter.
Oh my god. I will let you know if I find it.
Don't want the bartender poking around in there with a mop.
You are insane.
Are you...
Okay. Parvati, there are two things that I can think of. Either A, nobody's used this bathroom ever, which by the looks of it is not the case, or B, the owner and proprietor has never cleaned in here, because that wasn't exactly hidden. More along the lines of dropped behind it. Neither of those two options make me want to stay here any longer. Let's go talk to the vicar. Turn in this book of his. And then we'll go talk to Ludwig. And since the ship is there, we can head out at that point.
I suppose this means the two of you were able to sort out the matter?
Oh, boy. Well, it does seem like the better choice. None of her people are sick, and all of these people are sick.
The greater good can be difficult to determine. None of us can know the effects of our decision in a year, or 10, or 100. Take comfort in the fact that your choices are always, ultimately, in line with the grand plan.
I have got your book.
Wonderful. This is fantastic. Well worth all the sacrifices I... Wait. What the fuck is this? Is this French? I can't fucking read French.
Hey, now.
It's a law-forsaken joke is what it is.
Language!
I was so high and mighty, preaching to the yokels about following the plan, while fighting it at every turn.
You did not want the... Even I knew that.
Well, yes. But I assure you, it was not for personal gain, only for the greater good. I've spent my life searching for the keys to unlocking the secrets of the universal equation that underlies the plan. I had hoped this book held some of those answers, I became so desperate, I even got myself assigned to this plague-ridden backwater to find the damn thing. All the time and suffering I've spent. Wasted.
What I don't understand is all the time and hours of research you've put into this and you didn't know that the book was in French. Wouldn't that kind of be common knowledge? Or am I trying to logic a video game? That's never good. That's never... No, I need to stop doing that. At least you still have your mission.
Please. As if my life should have no greater meaning than proselytizing to a bunch of feeble-minded wretches. Nothing could be more excruciating than discussing the true nature of reality with people who have no interest beyond their next Aetherwave program. But that's neither here nor there. What I need to do now is to find a translator, obviously. But to do that, I'll first need to secure transport.
Oh, God.
You have a ship. Perhaps I could make myself of use to your crew.
I wouldn't mind a ship hand. I like that. You can clean my ship, bitch. I've already got one. Let's see how many we can have.
I already gave you most of my money, but I can offer you free spiritual counseling.
I don't
and
care.
I'd be happy to watch your back. I'm pretty handy with a toss ball stick, or any blunt instrument, really. I'm also a passable gun hand, if it comes to that. I can usually talk my way out of conflict, though. Oh, I'm fairly competent at hacking computers as well.
Well, now that could come in handy.
Fantastic. I promise you won't regret this.
Edgewater's gonna miss you. Folk here always had good things to say about their vicar.
Thank you, Ms. Holcomb. I'll be glad for the change of scenery and to leave this place behind. It is my esteemed pleasure to serve as your crew vicar, Captain.
I said ship hand, not vicar. Okay. Now that that is completed, let's go talk to Ludwig. Ludwig. Okay, we're going to talk to Ludwig. We're going to board the ship, and that's where I'm going to end it. We will continue next week.
Never seen the veil lit up like this before.
I found that package.
Meet your eyes, soldier. This here is a genuine Spacer's Choice injury customizing unit, designed to deliver a lethal blast of electrical discharge. I call it the Hand of the Law. You ever want to see a mechanical flailing around like a grounded fish? You stick a couple thousand volts in its guts. With compliments from old Ludwig.
Okay, so what's next?
Time's come for you to journey down into the black heart of the enemy's camp. I'm talking about the old geothermal plant.
Been there.
Unfortunately, the old plant lies outside my board-given jurisdiction. You'll need to get a passcode from the boss, Reed Thompson.
Already been there.
I've been after a passcode for years. Boss said no on account of my gross incompetence with all matters related to security.
That makes sense.
I need you to get us the brain of a mechanical. Well, not exactly a brain. Anatomically speaking, what we're looking for is a logic module. There's the rub. If a mechanical breaks down, the logic module fries. So you can't rip one out of its corpse. You're gonna have to find an intact model somehow.
I don't reckon so. I work with gears and pistons and such. Stuff you can put hands to. Computers and mechanical brains are outside my ken.
Damn it.
You know, she names the mechanicals she fixes. Calls them Bess and Clancy and so on.
So?
Keep a careful eye on her.
I
could
should
be a
kill
sympathizer.
You.
If you die horribly, I will pour out a can of zero-G to your memory.
Okay, I've got to go do this. I want to get everything done so I can get the hell off this planet. So we are going to actually fast travel. Oh, can I open? I can open this now. Yes! Of course it's nicely done because I am badass. Oh! I'm going to take a look around real quick and see if there's anything that I couldn't get into. Okay. I have the logic module. I'm back at the landing pad.
Never seen the veil lit up like this before.
I don't care!
Bang up, work soldier. You're a credit to your uniform. Oh, that reminds me. Gotta look into getting us a uniform. So this is it, then. The key to humanity's victory over the mechanical horde. I would reward you with the gratitude of the resistance, but I'm guessing you want something tactile. So here's a couple of bits for your trouble, and a little something to remember me by.
Don't make me insane. Thank you! Okay, I'm gonna do skill and perk points real quick while I'm here, and then we will head out. Now, okay. Okay, got the perks, got the skill points. Let's get the hell out of Dodge. Okay, so we know what we're doing. Ada, save me from my own people. Everybody's over here, good. Vicar is somewhere around. Okay, so we're gonna head out. A lot of stuff done. A lot more than I was expecting to have to do, but we got it taken care of, so yay us. But yeah, we'll continue this next week. Thank you very much for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And as always, I will see you at the next show.